The Young Designers Exhibition is back in physical form this year after going online last year due to the pandemic.
This year's event opens on May 14 with the latest in creative student designs. Formosa News reporter Stephanie Yang gets a preview of this year's show.
For a person who has a sudden heart attack, receiving CPR within 4 minutes can make the difference between life and death. To make it easier for bystanders to give CPR, students from Taipei Tech designed a hydraulic press that can produce twice the force of a human hand. The device, called LightAid, can save the rescuer's physical energy during CPR and facilitate a more effective rescue.
We have a statistic that usually healthy people or rescuers that perform CPR will usually start to get tired after 2 minutes, and after that the strength to give CPR is usually not effective for rescuing people. Main concept idea is the hydraulic press.
Another student invention is this infinity bubble. It's a small enclosed space that can be assembled quickly. Its outer layer uses negative pressure and filtration technology to block viruses.
So we hope the structure and the interior and architecture can provide something to prevent the coronavirus. I think the main concept that we provide is flexible and movable to do like a bubble structure interior or architecture. This is a HEPA filter, so air coming here, and we can do the mechanism to extend the space. So the air filter will be like a different layer, so this interior, the air is completely clean.
The more difficult part of the design work was thinking of how to transport it to affected areas of the world as soon as possible. We thought a lot about shape and form when designing this product. Right now in India, the crisis is most severe. They don't really have a way to protect themselves at home. Due to insufficient medical care, there's no way to achieve true isolation in the hospital, so this bubble house can actually be used for quarantine. It can be quickly transported and it opens when unfolded. When a family member has an infected person, they can live in there.
Another team of students designed a sustainable sanitary napkin that can be easily made by women in Uganda, where sanitary products are not always available. Their napkin is made of local agricultural waste.
We found two types of fruits. One is banana and the other is pineapple. These two are the most commonly produced fruits of Uganda. The leaves of the pineapples and the trunk of the banana trees are rich in fiber, so you can use this agricultural waste and then use these fibers to make disposable simple sanitary napkins.
These students' works were showcased at the National Taipei University of Technology and the Nangang Exhibition Center. These students' works are finalists for a Young Pin Award, which will be handed out at the Young Designers Exhibition. The event will be hosted at Nangang Exhibition Center from May 14th to 17th. For Formosa News, Stephanie Yang, Liu Bocong in Taipei.